So, you want to read more this year. Hello, wonderful world. Elayne here, and today I want to share with you some tips on how to read more in 2022. In talking to people in January, whether it be people from school or things that I've seen on social media, a lot of you all want to read more books in 2022. So I thought I would make a video talking about some tips on how to read more and knock out your resolution or your goals or whatever it is you set for yourself. Let's jump into some tips on how I personally read and make time for reading as a busy college student. So, I don't know about you, but I am kind of an English major. I am a literary management major, and a lot of my courses involve reading. A lot of reading. That being said, sometimes when I get home, the last thing I want to do is read more. So this leads me to my very first tip. Find what you like. Don't read something that you're not going to enjoy. You know, there are a lot of books out there that are thought-provoking and moving and really make you think, and they're reflections on the world, and they're New York Times bestsellers, and everybody's talking about them, and if you read them, they make you seem fancy, or it's a classic, and everybody's been talking about it for centuries. Sometimes you just don't want to read that. Sometimes you want to read a book about a vampire romance, or a mafia guy who falls in love with a good girl, or a demon hunter, or a fantasy world with elves and dragons. So if that's what you want to read, read it and don't feel guilty about it. You don't have to be reading The Great Gatsby or Jane Austen or some fancy novelist that everybody's heard of. You can read what you want to read. Any book counts as reading. And this is probably my most important tip. If you're not reading something that you enjoy, then what's the point of reading? Why would you force yourself to read something that you just don't like? You're not reading for a class, you're reading for enjoyment, and you're reading for you. So read what you want to read. And how I recommend to do this, if you haven't read in a really long time, is to look back on what you read as a kid. Were you really into Harry Potter and Percy Jackson? If so, maybe you should check out some really popular fantasy novels, like anything by Sarah J. Maas or Brandon Sanderson. Maybe you need some fantasy in your life, and maybe you want to escape the real world for a little bit and read about elves and dragons and quests. So maybe The Fault in Our Stars was more your speed. Maybe you were obsessed with those YA romance novels like Anna and the French Kiss and Paper Towns and you know the type. If that was more your speed, maybe you should check out Colleen Hoover. She has a lot of really good adult romance novels that kind of punch you in the gut. There's Ugly Love and She Has Slammed and Confess and It Ends With Us. She has a crap ton of novels that you could check out. And it's also okay to go back and read Percy Jackson, Harry Potter, The Fault in Our Stars. Read an old favorite to get you in that reading mindset again. Sometimes you just want to feel how those books you read as a kid made you feel. It's okay to go back and read those and feel so invested in the Hunger Games like you once did. It's totally fine to read old favorites or smutty romance novels or weird demon books or whatever you're into. Manga, graphic novels, comics, there's so many things that you can read. So find what you like. Speaking of that, my second tip is to try switching up your medium. You don't have to read a physical book. You can try ebooks. If you have a Kindle or a phone, you can read books on your phone now. You can try audiobooks. Audiobooks are something that I really got into last year. I never thought that I would be an audiobook kind of person because I tend to be a visual learner. I sometimes tend to zone out when people are talking for a long time, or if I'm in class and a professor is droning on, I can start to dream up a fantasy life for myself and picture a whole romance with the Prince of England and then I realize that I missed what the entire lecture is about. So I never thought that I would be an audiobook person, I just didn't think that I could focus on it. But then I found some that I liked, and now I love audiobooks. They're really great because you can listen to them while you're walking to class, or while you're eating lunch, or while you're cooking, or cleaning, or taking a shower. You can just put on your audiobook and you're reading while you're doing chores, which is like freaking fantastic. Sometimes I listen to it while I'm painting my nails. I can't turn a page while I'm painting my nails because that would be very problematic. I'll turn on an audiobook while I'm painting my nails, and the next thing you know, I've read a bunch of a book. And then like I mentioned, there are comics, graphic novels, mangas, just really amazing books with really amazing artwork that you can check out if you are a visual person and you want to see really cool pictures and artwork. You know, there's a lot of really good books out there. And what comes to mind when I say comics is usually superheroes and stuff like that. But there are so many different types of comics out there besides just superheroes, so check those out if that was something you were into as a kid. The next tip that I have is to schedule time for reading. If you don't schedule a time for yourself to read or just have me time, you need to check that. You need to evaluate your life. You should have downtime scheduled every day. It's something that I really recommend always. There should be at least 30 minutes of every day. Hopefully you give yourself an hour where you're just chilling and doing something that brings you enjoyment, whether it be watching a movie, whether it be painting your nails, or painting, or journaling, or reading. So for me, I like to make sure that at least for 30 minutes before I go to bed, I am reading. So I put my phone on Do Not Disturb, I put it on the charger, and it's basically as if I'm going to sleep, but instead I get out my little handy dandy book light and I read for 30 minutes and then I go to bed. So every night I make sure that I'm reading for at least 30 minutes. Now typically I read a little bit more, sometimes a little bit less, depending on if I had a really reading heavy day in school. But I always try to make sure that I'm reading for at least a little bit before I go to sleep. Maybe for you, you would prefer to read right when you wake up in the morning. Totally fine. Read for a little bit before you get out of bed. Maybe you want to read on your lunch break. That's fine too. Just make sure that you're scheduling a specific time of your day to take care of yourself, to rest and recharge, and to do something that brings you enjoyment, which hopefully is reading. And then another tip that I have that's kind of going off of that is take your book with you everywhere. I know that this isn't necessarily feasible for everyone, but for me, I carry my book in my backpack, and that way if I find myself having downtime, instead of reaching for my phone and mindlessly scrolling through Instagram, I can pick up my book and get a couple pages in between classes. Obviously, that's not gonna work for everyone. Maybe you can't bring your book with you to work or whatever you are doing, but there are so many times throughout the day where I find myself reaching for my phone and then just scrolling through Instagram or TikTok, and then I realize that an hour has passed. If instead of reaching for your phone and we were to all reach for a book instead, think about how many books we could read this year. Probably a lot. If I were to sub even half the amount of time that I spend on TikTok reading, I would probably read way more than I'm currently reading. The next tip that I have is don't force yourself to finish anything. If you're hating a book, put it down. Nobody's making you read it. Nobody's making you read or finish a book, I mean, unless it's for class. But for your own reading pleasure, nobody's saying, finish that book, or you're a failure, you're a quitter, da, da, da. Nobody is saying those things to you, okay? Sometimes we feel like that, and we feel like we have to force ourselves to finish something once we've started it, but that's not necessarily the case. If you're reading a book and you hate it, put it down. DNF it. Totally fine. Pick up something else that's more your speed, that's gonna get you more hooked and enjoyable. Because like I said, we shouldn't be turning something that's supposed to be pleasurable into something that's going to cause us stress and something that we're dreading. So those are the tips that I wanted to talk about. Just quick little thing to hopefully get you started reading this year. So for now, I wanted to give you all a couple books that I like to recommend for people who are jumping back into the reading world. One book is Throne of Glass by Sarah J. Maas. If you were a fantasy kid, if you liked The Hunger Games and Percy Jackson and Harry Potter and maybe some other books like that, Divergent, that kind of stuff, you should definitely check out Throne of Glass. It is a high fantasy young adult novel. It's got a lot of action, it's got a lot of really fun characters, and a lot of fun world building. Sarah J. Maas is an author that I highly recommend to everybody read, just because Sarah J. Maas is a really fun experience, and just so you can say you've read them. Sarah J. Maas is a really popular author, and you gotta jump out on that bandwagon because she is pretty good. I think she's a really great author, and her books are just full of amazing world building, so I highly recommend that if you're looking for something fantasy. If you're more of a romance person, you should definitely check out The Hating Game by Sally Thorne. It's about two people who work together, they don't like each other at all, and they are competing for the same promotion. But they quickly learn that hate may be really similar to love. It's a romance novel with a little bit of spice. It's one of the first enemies to lovers books that I've ever read. It really started me on my romance journey back in high school when I first read it. And it's got the perfect amount of spice just to introduce you to that world. And then the last book I'm going to talk about is The Seven Husbands of Evelyn Hugo. It's a very well-written story about a old Hollywood star. So she was really famous. She was a movie star back in the golden Hollywood era. And now she is old in modern day, and she has finally decided to tell her story. So she's had seven different husbands. She's been in a lot of movies. She's very beautiful, and she's finally telling it all to the world. And there is a very big plot twist, and it's very, very, very good. It will make you cry, it will make you think, and it's just very beautiful the way that it's written. So I gave you a fantasy book, I gave you a romance book, and then I just gave you a regular literature book. But those are three books that I recommend. And before you go, I just wanted to say one last tip is to follow me on TikTok. I know, self-promo, disgusting, boo, tomato, tomato, tomato. But anyways, if you follow me on TikTok at Elayne Reads, that's E-L-A-Y-N-E-R-E-A-D-S, I post a lot of book recommendations that I think would be great for you all as you try to read more this year. I've already posted one TikTok that says, if you liked this book, try this. And it has books such as The Hunger Games and Twilight. So definitely look for that. And also stick around on my channel because I post a lot of book recommendations and I have a lot of really fun things and videos lined up for this year. So hopefully you will stick around for 2022. And yeah. So I wish you all the luck in your reading endeavors. Remember, don't make something that's supposed to be pleasurable stressful. Don't create stress and chaos and pressure out of something that you yourself are striving to do more of. Don't turn reading into a negative experience. And I know that school has done that for a lot of us. And so as we try to read more for just personal reasons, let's try to keep it fun and light and quirky. And yeah, start small, read what you like, switch up the medium. Make sure that this is something pleasurable and you will have an amazing reading year. Thank you so much for watching. I hope that you stick around for 2022. And wherever you are, I hope that you are doing oh so well. And I will talk to you all soon.